morning, students. We have completed some topics like electric current as scalar quantity, then why it is scalar quantity, then current density, drift velocity, relation between drift velocity and electric field intensity. Today we are going to revise some topic and then we will discuss next topics. So student, this is the topic current density because it is very important. So we are going to revise first. What is current density? Current density at a point within the conductor is current through a unit area of conductor around that point, provided the area is perpendicular. So you can write J is equal to current I upon area. Okay, since you know that I is equal to NEAVD, so if you put the value of I here, then you will get J is equal to NEVD. Since current is a scalar quantity, so you can write I is equal to J, current density is vector quantity, so I is equal to data J dot A. Okay, so I hope you understand current density. Now the most important topic of this chapter is Ohm's law. Students, so the most important physical condition, the most important point you should remember, that in Ohm's law the physical conditions of the conductor, that is temperature, mechanical strain, these things should be unchanged. Means now I am going to give you statement of Ohm's law. You can see the electric current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to potential difference across the two ends of the conductor. Okay, but condition is, when physical conditions such as temperature, mechanical strain remains same. Okay, so you can see this is a conductor and this end, suppose this one is first and this one is second. So you can see end first is connected with the positive terminal of battery and end second is connected to negative terminal of battery. So there is potential difference. The same potential difference will be here. In this region, potential difference will be same as the potential difference in the battery. So if this potential difference is large, current in conductor is large. If this potential difference is less, current is less. So this shows that is V large. You can see from this relation, if V is large, I is large. So we can write V is proportional to I, R, some constant R into I, where this R is known as resistance of this conductor. Okay, so this one is resistance, this R is resistance, this is constant of a for a conductor if physical conditions are constant. Okay, if you plot a graph, you can see this equation is similar to the straight line equation, that is Y is equal to M X. Okay, so you can see Y is variable, this V is variable, X, I is variable, X is variable, and this R is constant, this slope is constant. It means if you plot graph between Y and X, you will get a straight line passing through the origin. So this is the graph between voltage and current for Ohm's law. This should be a straight line with slope. This slope will be equal to resistance, resistance of the conductor. Okay, so this will be equal to resistance of conductor. So this one is Ohm's law. I hope you understand. Now what is resistance? So the definition of resistance is given here with red color. The resistance of conductor is a position offered by conductor to flow of electric current through it. But student, why conductor opposes the flow of current? So if you see this structure, this one is suppose a conductor, it contains positive charge ions and it is completely filled with, because you know that solid has proper arrangement of atoms, okay. So this is completely filled with this. When suppose this one is electron, when this electron try to flow through this, it collide with different ions, okay. So it is very difficult to flow in this crowd of positive charge. So it feel some opposition or some difficulty in its motion. This is known as the resistance, okay. So that opposition offered by the conductor to the flow of electric current means charge actually, or you can say electron, through it is known as resistance. The mathematical or numerical value of that resistance R can be calculated by this relation, okay. R is equal to V upon I, where V is potential difference across the end of conductor and I is current, okay. Now resistance, we can write resistance in different form. So since we know that I is equal to this, we have already derived this formula. Now you can replace this Vd with this relation. This one is the value of Vd, where E is electronic charge, capital E is electric field intensity, M is electronic mass, and T is time interval. So this is now value of I, okay. Now E is equal to V upon L, potential gradient, okay. So E is equal to V upon L. So you can write N, now E into E is equal to E square into A into this time T upon this mass M. Now E is equal to V upon L, so you can write V upon length of the conductor. Now if you cross multiply this I here, you will get V upon I and remaining part will be R. So this one is multiplied here, okay. So V upon I is equal to, now this M into L will be here only, and N E square upon A T will be here, okay. So V upon I is equal to ML upon N E square A into T. So it means V upon I is equal to R, since we know that V upon I is equal to R, you can see here, okay. But here V upon I is equal to this term, this complete in the circle. It means actually R is equal to this much. It means R is equal to M into L upon N E square into T upon into A, okay. So this is equal to R. But if we consider about this bracket, this one is the constant for a given conductor. Mass of electron is constant, and is number of electron per unit volume. This is constant. E electronic charge, T is constant at given temperature. So this one is a special type of constant, and this is replaced by rho, that is known as resistivity or specific resistance of conductor into L by A. So you can see R is equal to rho, this bracket, into L by A. So this one is the relation, R is equal to rho L by A. But rho is actually M upon N E square T is resistivity or specific resistance. And this resistivity has some special characteristics, okay. But from this relation you can see resistance is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to cross-sectional area of conductor. So you can see R is directly proportional to L and inversely proportional to A. It means if wire is large or in length, means if for long wire resistance will be high and for thick wire resistance will be low. But this rho is characteristic property of given material. So for any length and any area of cross section, this remains unchanged. So you can see resistivity depends upon nature of the material and not on the geometrical dimension of the conductor. It means if length, area or anything will be increased, rho remains unchanged, okay. So I hope you understand the characteristic of rho is very important, okay. This is very very important quantity. This will be characteristic property of any given material, but not the geometrical condition of that conductor. Okay. So in the next slide you can see the rho in different form. Since you know that rho is equal to, from this relation you can write rho is equal to R into A upon L. Okay, you can write like this. Now R is equal to V upon I, so you can write rho is equal to E upon J. Okay, this one is the definition, electric field intensity upon current density. So E, now this one is the value of J. You have already noted this value in your slide. Now Vd can be written like this, Vd is equal to E upon N into rho. From this relation you can calculate drift velocity. Also you can calculate drift velocity from this relation. If you replace E is equal to V upon L, you can see here E is equal to V by L. If you put V by L, you will get Vd is equal to V upon N E rho into L. Okay, so these are very important formula for numericals. So I hope you understand. You can see here J is equal to this. Now when temperature increases, Vd decreases and rho increases. Okay, so for conductor, if temperature increases, then rho increases and Vd decreases. Okay, similarly when I increases, Vd decreases. So you can see the dependence of Vd on temperature with respect to specific resistance and current. So I hope you understand the variation of Vd with rho and with temperature, and variation of Vd with current I. Okay, next topic is conductance or conductivity. So I hope you know about conductance. Actually conductance is defined as the reciprocal of resistance. Okay, and its unit is 1 upon ohm, that is known as mho. You know that ohm is unit of ohm. This ohm is unit of resistance, so 1 by ohm is known as mho. So this is unit of conductance, because conductance is reciprocal of resistance. Okay, now conductivity is reciprocal of resistivity. So resistivity is rho, so 1 by rho is known as conductivity, and its SI unit is mho per meter. Okay, so you can see resistance R is equal to this. It means conductance is equal to N E square T A upon ML. Okay, you can write like this. And for conductivity you can write the relation. If you cross multiply, 1 upon rho is here, and you will get L by R into A. Or you can write from here, 1 upon rho is equal to, if you multiply here rho, and all this part is there, this side, so you will get rho, 1 by rho is equal to N E square tau, or T upon M. So this is value of rho, sorry, this is value of conductivity. So I hope you understand conductance means reciprocal of resistance, and conductivity means reciprocal of resistivity, and you have seen the units here. Now temperature dependence of resistance, you can see when temperature increases, the number of collision increases due to more internal energy and relaxation time decreases, therefore resistance increases. So it means the resistance of conductors, let me tell you one thing clear, this is only for conductors. So when temperature increases, the number of collision increases, and due to more internal energy and relaxation time decreases, therefore resistance increases. So this is only for conductors. Okay, so this statement is only true for conductor. For insulator and semiconductor we will study in next chapters. Okay, here you can see temperature coefficient of resistance, how resistance is varied with temperature. So you can see here if alpha is temperature coefficient, okay, then alpha can be calculated by the formula RT. It means resistance at temperature T minus R naught. R naught is resistance at 0 degree Celsius upon R naught into T, where T is temperature which is given. So you can calculate coefficient of resistance by this formula, okay, or you can use this formula. If R2 is less than R1, then alpha is negative and R0 is resistance at 0 degree, RT resistance at T degree, R1 resistance at T1 degree, R2 resistance at T2 degree. These two are for this relation, okay. So I hope you understand, and you can calculate, remember, you can calculate coefficient of resistance by using this formula according to the condition of the question. So you must remember these two formula, okay. I will try to give you the derivations of these two formula, but there is no need to derive. You can remember. If you it is needed, I will provide you, okay. So I hope you understand the temperature coefficient of resistance. Now our next topic is color code for carbon resistors. Student, this is very interesting topic. I hope you have seen resistors like this. On these resistors, there are circles of different color on the cylinder. This cylinder is actual a resistor. Okay, by using these colors, you can find out the value of the resistor. For this, you must follow something. So let me read this point. The first two ring from the end give the first two significant figure. So in this, on this cylinder, you can see the first ring is red. First, this one is the red color, this one is violet and black. Okay, so we start our calculation. We will start from this end, end number one. So first one is, you can see this one is the brown, then violet, you can say, and then this one is the black. Then how will we use these colors? So for this, let's understand. The third ring indicates the decimal multiplier. So in these colors, these two gives the two significant figure, and the third color gives multiplier, and fourth, the last ring indicates tolerance percentage. Okay, this one is the gold. But to use these things, let me explain a table. This is very important. So you can see this table, you should remember this table to find out the value. This table is very important. So letters are given here. The first letter is black. Black indicates 0. Then brown, it indicates 1. Then red, it indicates 2. Similarly, orange, yellow indicate 3, 4. Green, blue indicate 5, 6. Violet, gray indicate 7, 8. And white indicate 9. Okay. So there is very interesting method to remember this. You can write here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 number. And how you will write this? For this, you can remember B, B, Roy, then Great Britain, Very Good Wife. Okay, so एक बार बोल के प्रैक्टिस करते हैं. यहाँ लिखा हुआ है, look at this, B, B, Roy of Great Britain. We don't need this of. B, B, Roy of Great Britain has very good wife. Okay, so B, first B means black, then B, second B means brown, Roy R for red, U for orange, Y for yellow, we don't need this of, then G, G for green, then again B, Britain, B, B means blue, has very, we don't need this has, V means violet, good ka G lenge, G means grey and pipe ka. So you can write here 0, then 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, then 7, 8 and 9. So these are the numbers, so you can remember this thing easily. B.B. Roy of B.B. Roy of Great Britain has very good wife. Okay, by this you can, but most important point is you can see black, there is 3B, 1, 2 and 3. The first one is black. If there is black, you will take 0. If brown, you will take 1, and again if blue, you will take 6. It means 6 has largest value in 3B's, and there is 2G. 1G means green and other one means 8. Okay, so you must remember about B and G because these are repeated. Okay, so now you can see gold. If there is fourth ring is golden, it means tolerance is 5%. It means its value can be vary plus minus 5%. Similarly, if silver, it can be 10%, and if no color, it can be 20%. Okay, if there are only three color, let me tell you by giving example. So you can see in the first color is brown. So check the brown is 1. Okay, so you will write 1. Then second color is violet, check violet is 7. So you will write 1, 7 together, it will be 17, or it is 17. Now the third color give multiplier, so multiply into 10. Now check b is 0, so it is 10 to the power 0. Now fourth color is gold, so it is 5% tolerance. It means the value of this resistor is 17 plus minus 5% ohm. Okay, similarly for this, check by yourself, I hope you can. So first color is green, so check green is 5. Okay, so you write 5. Now second one is red, so check the value of red, that is 2. Now third color give multiplier, that is blue means 6. Okay, so if it is 6, it means you will write 52 into 10 to the power 6, it will multiply. Now fourth one is silver, so you can see silver, it means plus minus 10, you can see here ohm. So this is value of this resistor. Now you can do, or you can solve this one by yourself. Okay, so the first color is brown. Okay, this one is brown, so you should take 1. Now the second color is violet, this one is violet, so it will be 7. Third one is, so this one is the value, this one is actually, this one is not correct, this one is mistaken. So this one is 17 into 10 is for 10, but there is no color, it means plus minus 5 is replaced by plus minus 20, because fourth color is not present. So if no color, there is 20% tolerance. Okay, so I hope you understand the color coding of resistors. Take some examples given in your book and solve by yourself. This topic is very interesting and you will get very pleasure after solving these questions. Okay, I hope you understand these things clearly. So in the next video we will revise these things and solve some other questions based on this topic. Okay, thank you.